Publicly, do you know if, in fact, in any way, any of this was happening to you?
Well, I was interesting. I was listening with great interest to what Congressman Nunes just said. About 10 days ago, I received multiple contacts from the intelligence community suggesting that there may have been some inappropriate monitoring of my communications. It is not yet clear what that consisted of, whether it was just monitoring my social media using government resources. People raised the possibility that there were Privacy Act violations. But to date, my lawyers have not yet been able to get a full accounting of what happened. What Congressman Nunes just described, it's the first time I've heard a member of Congress describe it. It sounds similar to what the Intelligence Committee officials have been telling me for the last couple of weeks. It's early. We should get to the bottom of it. But as a journalist, it's chilling,
John,
to hear the possibility that, my communications in Ukraine might have been monitored.
John, I mean, this is mind-numbing to me. If U.S. Ambassador to Ukraine, you know, if there's evidence that government resources were used, if there's one journalist in this country that was digging into the Ukraine story, Peter Schweitzer in his book, Secret Empires, it was you. You interviewed Shokin, the prosecutor that was fired because Biden demanded it and blackmailed them into doing it.
Yeah, listen, it's not the first time I've been through this rodeo. If you remember back in 2002, 2003, the FBI acknowledged that Director Mueller, later to become the special counsel, but then the Director Mueller and his team had inappropriately intercepted my mail and kept it without a warrant. So I've been through this in the past, seeing government agencies potentially intrude on my First Amendment right to report. I also learned in that process, it's important to wait for facts to come out. I thought Congressman Nunes's comments were prudent. It's the beginning of an allegation. Let's find out what happened. But if it did happen, it's deeply troubling to me, and it should be deeply troubling to all Americans. But I think we need to dig in more. Ambassador Yovanovitch should be given an opportunity, and Secretary of State Pompeo should tell us what happened.
Well, there's a bigger story even beyond that that one day all of us will tell. Not right now. John Solomon, keep up the good work. Pretty disheartening, sad. We better get to the bottom of that when we come back.